guys, what's up? This is the first video of our series of adulting videos. So I recently moved out. I've been living alone for 3 months, and I would love to share with you guys what I found very useful in the process of moving out, in case you haven't already and are thinking to do so. So the first tip that I have for you guys is that when you are living at home with your parents, when you are being supported in that way, and you're also thinking about moving out, the best thing that you can do, I think, is to, one, save as much money as you can when you have all your bills being paid for and all of that, you know, taken care of. Save. And then also buy things that you might need when you move out while you're being at your parents. So for example, if you are in need for new clothes or in need for new like office stuff or technological stuff, or, you know, just make sure you get everything you need. Buy everything you could need before you move out, because it's very likely that once you move out and have to pay rent and bills and stuff like that, you are not going to, you know, at first have the money to buy all those things, maybe. So the great thing about living with your parents is that you can begin to strategize and, you know, make some moves in order to prepare the ground for when you move out. So the second tip that I have for you guys is to really take your time finding the space you want to live in. I had 2 failed attempts before I actually found the one that made sense to me and the one that I'm living in right now. And be patient with the process. You know, sometimes it's not the right time, and you have to allow your intention to be sent. You know, the universe knows that you want to move out. Set your intention very clearly of what you want, how you want it, and everything. And then be patient, because maybe it will take a few months for that perfect place to reach you, or that perfect place to be available in the first place for you. So something that you have to take into consideration is the safety of the place, because the first places I thought about moving out to, I even like paid the first month deposit and everything, and then I was actually mugged. There was like a robbery in my place, and I honestly, now that I think about it, that place was like perfect to have like something like that happen, because the doors were not secure, the windows were not really secure, and I honestly never even thought about that, because it was kind of like a country house. It was like far away from the city and like in a super chill place and stuff like that. But at the end of the day, safety is really important, and the ability to sleep well at night knowing that you're safe is a great thing to have. So when you look at a place, make sure that it's really safe, that if it's a building, it has like police guards and stuff like that. If it's a house, like make sure like it's protected, it's in a good area, it's surrounded by, you know, like light, it's you know, it has light outside, so you can like see people going walking around, stuff like that. Other thing that is very important is be very realistic about the price. Find the best price you can, the best value for your money, and negotiate. You can always negotiate the price down. You don't have to have the price that is, you know, set. You can always ask and insist and find a price that is really, really safe for you. Almost try to get a price that you say, oh my god, really? You know, is that cheap? You know, like, if you find that kind of place, you're gonna know that you can pay the rent very well. And you're gonna need the first month and an additional month of, like, the deposit. This serves in a way in which the owner protects themselves by charging you that extra month at the beginning. So if by any chance you ruin something in the apartment, one of the furnitures or something happens to the apartment, they can take the money out from that to fix it. So if you don't complete the contract completely, like if you are in a 1-year contract and you choose to leave before, they will take that and keep that as a guarantee for their own you know, comfort, right? So it's important for you to know that that's the kind of money that you're going to need. So choose a price that can work with you. Be very honest with yourself, in the sense that, do you want roommates? Do you want to live alone? Be very honest with yourself. Because sometimes we feel like, oh, it's going to be great to have roommates, it's going to be so fun, it's going to be amazing. And then you're with the roommates and you realize that they're coming in and out of the apartment, they're not being honoring their word, then you're left with debt, or then you're left with unexpected needs to cover a bigger percentage of the rent. Think about it. Think about what really serves you and what is going to be most comfortable to you on a day-by-day basis. Also, Okay, so that was a mix of the tip number two and the tip number three. My tip one was prepare. Save and buy stuff while you're at your parents or in a different, living situation where you're being supported. Step two, find the perfect place and price and make sure to negotiate. That was my tip two. Three was choose safety, comfort, and be honest about what you need, which is tip three. Tip four is, okay, so what you're going to need to make this happen varies in every country, right? If you work independently, you're going to need to maybe go to the bank and have this like financial statement of how much money is coming in and out of your account in order to present that to the owner of the apartment so they know that you actually do have the money to go through with this and go through with this in a long term. You're also going to need probably, well, I mean, the first month, the deposit month, and I would suggest you have maybe 2 months saved just for you to have peace of mind. Especially is if you work as a therapist, a healer, or someone who works independently, I would suggest you have that in the bank, like waiting there, just in case. Always be kind of like months ahead, so you don't have the stress of not finding, the money at the end of the month or something like that. What else would you need? Well, make sure. And for me, it was way more comfortable to have the apartment being furnished, like having all the furniture inside already included in the price. Make sure that it is an area in which you can have great Wi-Fi if you work through like internet and stuff like that. If you know, be very picky. Manifest the place that you want. Make a list of everything you want. Do you want a garden? Do you want a terrace? Do you want outdoors? Do you want a peace and quiet? Do you want to be in the big city? Do you want to have friends around? Do you want to be alone? Do you want to be in nature? Make sure you're very specific about all the details and manifest it. If you need help manifesting anything, we have a Manifesting Magic online course you can check out. I'm going to be leaving the link below. And it will give you all the steps you need to manifest basically anything you want, not only the apartment, but like anything you desire. And then my last tip is, when you move out, don't use boxes to carry your stuff to a new place. Use travel bags. Like the bags you use for traveling, the ones with the, like carrying bags, the normal big bags with wheels. Those bags are actually great for moving around your stuff. Boxes tend to be very uncomfortable, then you can't find your stuff anywhere. And with the bags, it's very easy to walk in and out and do several trips in order to get all of your clothes, all of your bathroom stuff, all of your stuff to the new place. So that is a great tip that I found actually through another YouTube video that I was able to use when I moved in and out from my parents, and it was great. It was very, very comfortable. So make sure you get organized with your bills. Make sure you have a little chart telling you all the bills that you need to pay, by which date you need to be paying them, and start adulting. It's exciting. So I hope this was helpful. Let me know if you have any additional questions. I've been only here for 3 months, so I'm not as pro adulting as maybe other people, but it's a great experience and I highly, highly recommend it. I feel way happier. I feel way more in connection to myself, I guess. And I would love for you to experience the same if you're in that desire to do so. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please subscribe to our channel. I'll be leaving links below so you can visit our website too, where we have a lot of tools about your spiritual awakening. Bye, guys.